There's one more train after that one. We can't let any more of the gold make it to Shima. We've got to make it to the bridge ahead of the train.
Over here. You're the Yank we're expecting, eh? We saw your mates land up ahead. Come with us, we'll take you there. Troops ahead. Dug in tighter and a rugged scrum.
Demonstration! 俺に勝てるとでも思ってるのか。
Mop up any stragglers.
Thank you. but I managed to get a bit of information. These were Shima's men, and this was his train. The whole bloody thing is filled with gold for that plan of his. He's headed for a ship he's on. We need to get there. But first, let's get off this bridge. Have you seen Tanaka? I lost him somewhere back there. Hope he's okay. He's beginning to like that man. Get back!
Going carry-oning.
Despite heavy losses in battleships during the attack on Pearl Harbor, the United States fleet was able to maintain their naval strength. This feat was accomplished by the strategic use of aircraft carriers, as the United States quickly determined that air power was the future of naval superiority. The Japanese realized this as well, and began amassing one of the largest fleet of carriers the world had ever seen. The two seagoing forces met at Midway in early June of 1942. After 3 days of intense fighting, the Japanese had lost many of their large carriers and were forced to retreat. The victory at Midway marked a turning point in naval warfare. No longer were the number of battleships the most important factor. The nation with the greatest carrier fleet was king.